morning.
Time. We've got a couple of brush fires out there and one or two coastal showers. So a lot going on. Let's break it down with a look outside first, and we'll get to the timeline. We'll show you the gusty winds, and that is a pretty looking picture right there. You're looking at towards Claremont and the Four Corners area, and tell you what, the atmosphere is about to change out there. There's a good reason for it. Let me show you what's ongoing now across the northern and the northeastern Gulf of Mexico. A powerful cold front is really cranking on up, and it's pulling in a lot of moisture into the southeastern half of the United States. Now, with low pressure this far to the north, generally speaking, central and south Florida does not see a lot of severe weather. That's not to say we won't have any thunderstorms tomorrow. There is a tornado watch just north of I-10 from Tallahassee on into the Atlanta GA area. But you can see that moisture. This is the Yucatan Peninsula. And typically speaking, when you get moisture being pulled off of that into a system, it's a fairly vigorous storm. And that's what we're dealing with right now. The timing, though, is the bigger concern here. This one is racing quickly off now towards the east northeast. And it looks like we're going to see some of the showers and storms arrive quite early before sunup tomorrow in our northwestern locales out there out ahead of it. We've got a few coastal showers. We've got a few brush fires. Let's zoom in a little bit closer here, kind of pinpoint a few of the things we're noticing. We've got one big brush fire over towards St. Cloud. Just got a picture in the inbox. Show that to you here in the next half hour. And another one over towards the Kennedy Space Center. And then a fast-moving shower popped up just west of Holly Hill, right over the Speedway, racing off towards the north and the east. And there's a good reason why it's racing off to the north and the east. We've got breezy south to southeast winds, 10 to 20 miles an hour. We've had an occasional gust as high as 25 to 30 earlier, now running in the 15 to 25 mile an hour range. And look at these temperatures. Officially, 85 degrees at Orlando International Airport. Folks, that's 1 degree shy of the record for the date. That's just to kind of put things into perspective for you this afternoon. 68 at midnight, 63 in the morning, breezy through mid-evening, overnight lows well above the seasonable norms, 61 Ocala, 69 Melbourne, over towards Daytona Beach coming in at about 64 degrees. All right, having said that, now let's time this out for you. Here's FutureScan doing a good job picking up on those coastal showers, and then watch the timing of the front. Here's 4 a.m., the first batch of energy. Then the secondary piece of energy with the actual cold front, late morning, early afternoon. So two rounds of rain, most of us picking up about a quarter of an inch of rain, but the amounts may be a little bit heavier north and west as that energy moves on shore. And then into the weekend, clouds hang tough across the south, sunnier up north, rainfall totals a half an inch from Ocala north and west, with lighter amounts from Orlando on south and east. Having said that, here's a peek now at that 7 day, 67, 73, 73 in between tomorrow, 78 degrees, a good 7 degrees cooler than today. Rain chances running at about 50%. Then as we head into the weekend, the forecast gets a whole heck of a lot better. A lot of clouds, Jim and Martha, 76 there on Saturday, and a little bit cooler Sunday on into Monday. We're back into the low 70s.